moving the cage, doing all making these extras. First fight of Fusion, fighting tonight. Good one, hopefully it's just following the footsteps of it. Last we've got the crowd going wild. This looks to be a similar kind of matchup.
Indeed. And everyone that was always watching out for the heavier weights, they love the big guys throwing bombs at each other, and this fight will be fought at 93 kilos. It's a light heavyweight.
Yeah, it'll probably be a very different kind of fight from the last. Difference in weight. Be interesting to see, like I said, are they going to be looking for that knockout? At this weight, it happens a lot more, you know. Guys that light heavy hold a lot of power. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I agree.
Support for him as well. Big guy.
And this is what the crowd like to see. Intimidating specimen of a man, isn't he?
Absolutely, man. He's a big guy. Like I said, that part at the beginning when they stare each other off is going to be interesting. I like this guy's style, like the walkout music he's got. Bringing something different to fusion fighting. Touches before he enters the cage, getting the Vaseline put on. Final check. It'll be over to our Fusion Fighting Championships commentator, Buddy Johnson. Support for Jake Castle again, the Punisher. Let's see if he lives up to that name. Both fighters going straight for it.
Oh, Hayes looking for the takedown, the single, doesn't get it. Castle ties up the neck, muscles him to the cage. Wow. Puts in body shots here, throwing knees.
Kind of scrappy at the minute, they're both exerting a lot of energy. Will this fight settle down? Let's see.
I feel like Haynes has to survive this onslaught initially. Wow. Needs to stay relaxed, to keep cool. And again, looks for that leg. But Castle then ties up the neck immediately. Gets him back to the same position, puts the knees in.
Single again. Now double, drives into the cage.
He looks, pushes him against the cage. Now Castle can't sprawl away from him. Has he got his hands linked? I can't see from here. No.
Not quite. Both hands are high. He could drop at this position. Yeah. He could drop to the double.
He's pinning high at the minute.
Yeah. Oh, nicely done.
Very nice.
Pulls him off the cage, straight into full guard of Castle. Let's see how the action goes now on the floor.
Yeah, Jake tying his hands up at the minute.
Yeah.
Keeping nice and tight. Doesn't want him to release some hands and punch at the minute. See if he can work his guard a little bit. Legs tied up, just closed guard at the minute. Yeah. Be good to see him open it up, start working for sweeps. Oh. Nice little hammer fist.
He's doing a good job at the moment of controlling the arms. Looks for the, is he looking for the arm lock here? Yes, he is.
It's interesting. He's going for it. He's got out of that. Oh.
He gets the stand up.
Stiff jab. Driver against the cage again. That's a nice short right hook there in the pinch.
Oh, and the same takedown again. He gets the double underhook, gets the body lock, swings him down, trips him, puts him down. Nicely done. Obviously been drilling that quite a lot.
Indeed. Once again, same position, working him little right hands.
He needs to watch the active guard of Castle here as well. He steps over. Is he going to clear that leg? No, he does not.
I think Castle just needs to start working the submissions, trying to get back to his feet, working the sweeps. It's not good just tying them arms up. He's got 10 left.
It's been an active round, this one.
Indeed. A little bit scrappy, but I think the next round these guys might settle down a little bit. There
scrappy but fast pace. You know, it's the pace is the key thing.
Fights, you get the nerves, the adrenaline pumping through them. Sometimes it just takes that first round for you to settle down.
Yeah.
Think to yourself, right, now I've got to do what I train at the gym. I have to put what I train into practice and get back to my game plan.
So, it was a close round, I'll be honest. I felt the aggression came from Castle, but I think...
Round two, here we go. Castle now responding.
Oh, he looks for the takedown. He falls into mount here for Castle.
Yeah, went for that inside.
Really bad position. This is going to be a real problem for Haynes.
Went for that inside leg reap. Didn't go to plan. He needs to start bumping his hips, controlling them arms, because at the minute.
Yeah, although Haynes isn't really putting any damage in this ground and pound. I don't think it's going to cause any problems. And if Haynes can tie this up, get the ref to stand up, or he looks like he's going to try and bridge his way out.
Absolutely, he has to bridge his way out. Try and push that knee for half guard, maybe.
There we go. He needs to slip that leg through the middle.
Power it.
And he does.
I'll
be honest, I don't think I've ever seen that in my entire life. Bridging out of mount straight into guard. Amazing.
Interesting technique. And now he's throwing the shots back in return. Again, Jake just trying to tie them arms up at the minute. And he passes the half guard.
Oh, straight round to side control. Nicely done. Is he going to look for the full mount here? Is he going to hunt an arm?
That's too easy, man.
I know. And if I was in Castle's corner, I'd be telling him to walk his legs to the cage. Trying to get out. Oh, he goes for the arm lock. Has he got it straight? Yes, he has. He has. Is he going to tap? Yes, he does.
It is all over, Tim. There it is.
Wow. Lovely finish.
You know... Here's the thing, when Jake was underneath, he was just trying to tie up. He was almost like he was trying to survive a little bit. And that time, Addix finished it with an armbar.
Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for these two warriors. Come on! This round in 2 minutes and 5 seconds on the third second round. Team winner by submission, Alex Hunter! tonight. Everybody went cool. It went both ways. Incredibly fast start to first round. Very reserved as well. The shot was out. Part of the game plan, and you just put a lot of pressure on.
No, I knew he was going to come out fine in the first round, but I knew he didn't have his target. He was very patient. And as you can see, the second round was 4 years ago. There's just giving him the opportunities to sit out and do the arm up. So, yeah.
And as you got a couple of great takedowns in the first round. The last round you were in, you went for that leg break, ended up in rounds. So, planning for your leg. Was the arm lock, was that submission, was that going to be the fight ender for you tonight, or was that your main arsenal?
Yeah, I was definitely thinking of doing that, and it was at the right time, so I took it.
It was a great fight. Anyone you want to thank tonight?
Big thanks to Victor McCoy, who we go, you know, training 3 hours a day for, and the rest of the team at home, and also my mum and dad and my brother, pushing me and supporting me, so yeah, I proved a lot of people wrong tonight, so. It's a big thing for me.
Well done. Congratulations, man.